it's like we've been talking. This is a time of year that we need to enjoy. So you should enjoy it. Thank you for being here this morning. You heard the announcements made, so thank y'all for that. We're busy, busy in December. So we're excited to be here this morning. I trust you are too. Come back tonight, be a part of our Christmas play with us at 6. Now, one time, I'll get in trouble if I don't. If you're in the play, what time are you supposed to be here?
4 or 5.
You're married to it, son, because I'll let you deal with it, right? Simple enough. But we're excited you're here. But I found out something this morning, so I got to do something this morning. I found out Miss Jean wasn't going to be here this evening. So the choir's got him something. And we're going to give it to him, Miss Jean. Here you go, Miss Jean.
They're the ones that make this happen.
Don't talk too sweet till you see what that is. Your pastor bought that.
It's an alligator case. Oh my goodness. Look at this. And you know what? I told Sarah, y'all see that? It's all of these beautiful. And it's in its own case.
Yeah.
And I heard Vestal Goodman singing White Christmas. I've never heard that before. Thank y'all so much.
Thank you. Know, let me show you something there, Jim. When I found this, and this is the thing about it, I found this just like it is.
Okay.
But look at this one. This is what caught my eye.
It's here, family, because of him. Wow.
You ain't read the cards yet.
We got one. It's in that machine that does everything that I don't know how to work. We found these just for you. Bet you have something to play them on. Believe it or not, I've got a great collection. Thank y'all so much.
I'm telling you, you got to enjoy this time of year. You got to enjoy. Got a lot of requests, a lot of prayer requests. A lot to pray for. Got a lot of sick inside the church right now, so let's be much, much in prayer for that. So let's pray together this morning. Father, we love you, Lord. We thank you for being such a great God, Lord. We thank you for this time of year, Father. We thank you so much, Father, for just coming and sitting down with us and allowing us to enjoy you and your Son, Father. We thank you for this time of year, Lord, the birth of salvation as it came into this world, Lord. We love you today. We lift up all those names that's been mentioned on our prayer request list this morning in Sunday school, Father. I pray you reach down and touch, heal bodies where it be, and you will, Lord. But Lord, we pray you will be done, Father. But Lord, at this time this morning, Lord, I pray we put everything else aside, Father, and we just come and worship you in the spirit and the truth, Lord. We ask for fresh anointing from above this morning, Lord, and we just ask that you be real with us today, Lord. We appreciate you, we love you, and we thank you, Lord. This thing we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Don't forget, Lottie Moon offer this morning. Anybody need an envelope? We got them right here. If you need one, but Charles will be tending to that here in just a little bit.
Number 285.
Thank you.
then we'll go into the...
Thank you.
young woman with the radiant smile. She was leaning against one of the stalls, and the eyes in the happy face were closed. The man was at her side, and behind them, in the manger, where the cows came for food, was the baby. He was a tiny thing, wrapped tightly in a long linen band, and sleeping as soundly as any newborn baby. Sleeping as though the world had not waited thousands of years for this moment. As soundly as though your life and my life and the life of everyone on earth were not wrapped up in his birth. As though from this moment on, all the sin and sorrow of the world were not his problem. Should you speak to his mother resting so quietly there? Should you ask her if you might touch the baby? Not to wake him, but just to touch his hand. What a moment that would have been to have reached out your own hand and touched the Son of God.
There's something about that.
Thank you.
taking our Lottie Moon offering this morning. And what was our goal? We had to get to light the tree.
500.
Sorry. No, I was kidding. Y'all wondered though, didn't you? Janet's got two or three more back there. How many you got, Janet? That's what I thought about this. Don't you listen to this? I thought about this when I saw Charles and Matthew go back to camp. And I thought, Lord, they'll have to take their shoes off. They may be there a while to get it done. But they got it done, so that's what matters. But we're excited this morning to have a brand new face.
Amen.
Here, we've been looking for it. And I don't blame them either. Kept him away from us, too. But we're glad to have Jacob and Ashley back this morning. Isabella and Jax. He's hidden back there this morning. You might well get him out. He's asleep, isn't he?
Don't get him out.
Because he's fixing to plug the lights in.
Oh.
I've been praying. I said, when we get this money raised up, who am I going to get to plug the lights in? And lo and behold, here comes Jax. I said, man, this is his first Christmas here. His first Christmas period. He gets to plug the lights in this morning. He can handle it.
$270.
So that brings us to $875. Woo! Oh, wait a minute. Jean still got her kid over there. Jean's is probably $1,000. Jean's is probably $1,000. $880. See what God does? He just comes in and he does great things and he allows us to be a part of that. So we get to light the lights this morning. And
somebody get a picture of that.
We're going to. I ain't got my camera phone enough. They're trying to untie it. Ashley knows how. Jacob don't. Ah, oh, look at it. Y'all come on. Y'all come on. First Sunday. Y'all get to plug the lights in this morning for the Lottie Moon tree. Woo-hoo! This week, baby. Look this week, baby. And right now, he don't care, sir. $2 a sock. Look at it. Look at that. First Sunday. Woo-hoo! Yeah! All right. Thank y'all. Well, we're glad y'all are here this morning. Man, we're so thankful you're here today. Do you take a picture? There you go.
Hey, don't be kissing on him.
Right. Look at him. Gawk over him. But keep a distance. Keep a distance. Because you know there's stuff going around everywhere. We don't want that babysit. We do not want that baby sick. We're glad you're here today. I tell you what, the Lord has had a thought in my mind for a couple of weeks now, and he's going to allow me to share it with you this morning. And, you know, we come to this time of year, especially last weekend. We didn't know that was coming last weekend, did we? Man, that took us all by surprise and storm. And you know what? Listen to this. At some point in time last weekend, you were the victim and you were the worst one in the world, wasn't you? I'm being honest. That's the way we do. That's the way we roll. Okay, last Friday night, nobody was going through what I went through last Friday night. It was all on me. It was all mine. I was having that pity party because I had 200,000 chickens and I was afraid they was all going to die. I stayed up all night and babysat every one of them. Nobody was going through what I was. It was terrible. Y'all ever been that way? But you know, it really wasn't bad as I made it out to be. But at that point in time, it was all about me. As many of you went through different things this past weekend in the different situations with power outages and snow and all that stuff, at some point in time, your situation was the worst one in the world, wasn't it? Your things were the worst one in the world. But you know, and as bad as yours might have been,
As bad as mine might have been, there was somebody going through something a little bit worse. There was somebody going through something a little bit worse. So we wonder why we had need for a Savior. This verse has been hung in my mind for a couple weeks now. Excuse me. Book of Luke. Chapter 2. Look with me just quickly. One verse this morning. I want to share one verse with you this morning. One verse only. You know this story by heart. You know the whole thing by heart. You've heard it your whole life. But here's the thing. You got to learn to see it in a different light. Luke chapter 2, verse 11. I used this in a reference a couple of weeks ago when we were talking about Judah and King Hezekiah and how Judah was in such a mess. And God sent King Hezekiah right at the perfect time, right in his timing, and right with the plan that God had. And Hezekiah executed it just like God wanted it done and began to evolve Judah out of the situation that they were in. Listen to this. I love this. We've heard it a thousand times. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ our Lord. A Savior, which is Christ the Lord. You know, when you come today and you hear the songs on the radio, did you know Christmas has become a time of want rather than a time of need? Because you ask people what they want. You look for what they want. You listen to the radio. Somebody wants their front teeth. Somebody wants a hippopotamus. Tommy wants a pistol. Susie wants a dolly. You see, those are all wants. And if we come in here today and we see the wants, can I tell you what happened in this verse right here? What happened in this place right here, the angels came to the shepherds, the lowest form, what was considered the lowest form of humanity in the Jewish society. The angels came to the shepherds, did not ask them what they wanted, told them what they were getting and what they needed. What they needed. But see, they still didn't have a clue. We come to this time of want, but at this point in time, it's the first thing I want you to see this morning. Listen to this. Out of that one verse, they were not asked what they wanted. God knew what they needed. God knows what you need today. God knows where you stand today, and God knows what you need today. We've got our wants, and sometimes we have such a hard time discerning between a want and a need, don't we? We got things that we want desperately, but we don't need them. God knew what they needed. But listen to this. Not only did God know what they needed, God provided the answer. He provided exactly what they needed at that time. He told them, he said, unto you, look here, this day, that's right, that day, that very day, he said, listen, there's a Savior in the city of David being born right now for you. He provided them an answer. And this is why this is so great, church. This is why this is so great this morning, because it had been a long time since God had spoken. You go back and look, you take from the Old Testament to the New Testament, about a 400-year period right there when God hadn't spoken. And why do you say that? How do I know that? Because if God had spoken, it would have been recorded somewhere. It would have been in His Word somewhere. So this time frame comes in. Then all of a sudden, when God decides to speak again, He's looking at a nation. He's looking at a people. And He didn't come in and ask them what they wanted. He gave them what they needed. He provided what they needed, and He laid it out just as they needed it. And listen, when He spoke, boy, He spoke in a mighty way. Don't you love it when God speaks in a mighty way? Having a conversation this morning about how God's been just working in the life of people the past couple of weeks. Even in diverse situations, God has worked in the life of people. Has He worked in yours? Have you heard what He said? Did you listen to Him? Listen, in those dire times of need that we were in last weekend, did you hear what God had to say? Sometimes God slows us down. Why did God send a snowstorm to us? I have no idea, but we needed it for something. There was a reason in it. There was a cause in it, and it's our job to search out what God had for us in that snowstorm. Help you on your power bill. Didn't it? A couple days without power, says help on the power bill a little bit. Listen, all the electronics were cut off for just a little while, wasn't it? Was this still available? Was this still available last week when the power was out? God knew what you needed, and he had already given it, but did you use it? Did we pick it up and look at it? They were not asked what they wanted, but listen to this. They did not know what they needed. There was a Messiah that was prophesied, but when they saw the Messiah coming, they saw a great king coming to save the world, to save Jerusalem. They saw him in a whole different light. That's what God had. They did not know. Listen to me. We're in a society today. We're in a world today, just as those shepherds were, the way they were taught. They did not know they needed saving. They didn't know they needed saving. We're in a world today. Listen to me. Somebody needs to be saved. We're in a world today that needs salvation that came through this child that was born. God knew what we needed. But we look around today, and I want you to hear me when I say this. The reason that we don't see people saved is because, listen to this, they didn't know they were lost. People don't know they're lost today. They don't know they're lost in the world today. They don't know they're lost in their sins today. They don't know they're lost in the things that God had today. When God spoke to the shepherds, he said, guess what? I know what you need. You need salvation that'll only come through this child that I am, look here, giving you. I am giving you this child. He didn't ask them. He told them. If you ask a child the wants of Christmas, is the needs they need going to come out? Are they going to say, well, I could really use and need this? They're going to say, I want this. You know, we were talking the other day, and this is how times have evolved. Used to, when we were growing up, of course, we all grew up kind of poor. You know, when we grew up, Christmas was a time to get new clothes. Because you got clothes at the when school started, and you got clothes at Christmas. And guess what? Those clothes at Christmas was going to carry you to the end of school. If they didn't, you was in trouble. I stayed in trouble a lot. Because I was rough on my clothes. But if you go ask a child, what can I get you for Christmas? They're not going to give you a need. They're going to give you a want. If they had to come down, what if God had spoken with the angels and came to the shepherds and said, what do you need? What do you want right now instead of what you need? You know what they would have answered? Shoot, it's cold out here, man. How about a tent with a fire in it? Or how about some shelter? How about a side-by-side? It'd be a whole lot easier for us to tend to these sheep if we had a side-by-side. It'd be a whole lot easier for us to tend to these sheep if we had something to ride rather than having to walk and lead them. They could get behind us. We could ride. They could walk. Man, we'd be great. Times hadn't changed, folks, I'm telling you. The thought process of man in this day and these shepherds is the same thought process that we have today. It was just a different time frame. If God had asked them what they wanted, a Savior would not have come out of their mouth. If God asks us what we want, we lay the list out there 9 miles fold. But he knows exactly what we need. So they came and they didn't understand they were lost. They did not know at that point in time. They had no idea, and they did not know what God was doing for them. It wasn't rescuing. They were afraid to start with. Fear came over. But they didn't have a clue. This point in time, exactly what God was doing. A Savior. A Savior. Listen to this. And they didn't understand what they got. How many times, my kids have been through it, I've been through it, your kids, grandkids, whatever. They get in the floor when it's present time. You know, when we're kids at my granny's house, everybody's got that one aunt, don't they? That eats for 3 hours. Y'all have that? They eat for 3 hours. And you're sitting here, man, and you know the presents are over there, and you've done whooped down your food, and you're sitting there, and listen to this, and I love this woman, but I ain't long, I'm still sitting at the table. Mama, Mama, when are we going to get the open presents? She said, as soon as Aunt Lonnie gets done eating. It's going to be next week. We'll be back in school. And you're sitting there. And Aunt Lola's eating, and she's prim and proper, and she's always fixed. And she's sitting at the table, and she's eating one little bite at a time. And you're going, oh, will she please hurry up? Y'all ever been there? Kids are bouncing off the wall. You done run around the house three times. Mama done slapped you twice. You been there? We just didn't understand. And then when it was time to open those presents, y'all remember this? And everybody jumps down in the floor and all the kids are there and you start snatching paper off and you really had no clue what you even had. You really didn't have a clue what you even had. What was even there? Can I tell you something? As these shepherds sat there and as that angel spoke to them and as that angel said, today in the city of David, you have a Savior. They didn't understand. They did not understand. They didn't understand the life value that was being given them. We don't understand that today. We don't understand the life value that comes to us through a Savior. Listen to this. They did not understand life value, but they just didn't understand everyday value. Well, let me ask you something. Was the same God with you last weekend that's here this morning? The same God that was in a stressful time that was with you, is he the same God that's here this morning? Is it the same God that loves you? Is it the same Savior? Yeah. We just don't understand sometimes. We don't understand how this functions, how this works in our life. We don't understand the everyday value of a Savior. I know some of you, you look for value. You want value. But we don't understand the value that comes through a Savior. Not only did they not understand life value, they understand the everyday value, but listen to this, they had no idea about the eternal value that was coming that day. They had no idea about eternal value. And see, what happens is, a lot of times this time of year, listen to me, church, a lot of times this time of year, eternal value leaves our thought process. We're not worried about eternal value. All we're worried about is the baby Jesus. Can I tell you something? The baby Jesus is the reason you have eternal value. So we have to say, this is what this Savior did. They didn't understand much more then as we do now of what that Savior meant for us. Christmas means salvation through Jesus Christ. Here's what it means. Listen to this. We have a Savior that's bigger than ourselves. What did we need saving from? Ourselves. What did we need saving from? Us. Me. I needed saving from me. Why? Because I had a sin nature that was running rampant. I had a life that was running rampant. And the only thing that could give me value in that life was a Savior. A Savior. So we don't think about it that way. Listen to this. We needed saving from ourselves. But I want you to understand something this morning. This Savior that was born, this Savior that we have, hear this. Everybody's ears open? He walks on the stuff you're drowning in. That's my Savior. He walks on the things that you are drowning in. Just like Peter, no different than Peter, when Peter saw Jesus walking on the water and he said, Lord, I want to come to where you are. And he bailed out of the boat. What's the first thing he did? He sank. But listen, Jesus didn't save until he cried for help. When he cried, Jesus reached down and kept him from drowning. Whatever situation that you're in today, I have a Savior. You have a Savior because of the shepherds, because of the angels, because of what took place that night. You have a Savior that's greater than you are. You have a Savior that walks on whatever you're drowning in today. And can I tell you, in a life we live in today, everybody's drowning in something. Everybody's drowning in something, but my Savior is bigger than your stuff. He's bigger than your stuff. He's bigger than your health. He's bigger than your family. He's bigger than your finances. He's bigger than whatever it is that's got you down. For unto you this day, a Savior. But listen to this. We didn't understand that we needed saving from hell. They didn't understand at this point. As long as I carry my lamb every year, and as long as I go to the Day of Atonement, as long as the sacrifice is made for my sins, and as long as I do that one time a year, I'm good. They did not know that they needed saving from a devil's hell. Can I tell you something? When we were lost in our sin, we did not understand that we needed saving from a devil's hell. And we don't understand that today. We sit here today and say, preacher, why do you want to bring salvation and hell at Christmas? It's because of Christmas you have a way out of hell. Because let me tell you something. Hell is just as hot in the snow as it is in the summertime. Okay? And let me tell you something. This Savior that the angels are talking about, let me tell you something. This Savior does not save us to the almost, but to the utmost. He does not almost save us. He does not almost get us there. He doesn't bring us to a place of almost. He brings us to the place of utmost. A place that you could not get without a Savior. A place that you could not get without Christmas. A place that you could not get without a baby. Did the shepherds understand all this stuff? Absolutely not. Do you understand all this stuff today? Absolutely not. And can I tell you something? Here's what you need to know today. And here's what you need to understand today. When I accepted Jesus Christ, when I accepted him as a personal Savior, and he became the Lord of my life, there is nothing I can do to lose my salvation. Nothing. But if he had not been born, he could not have died. If he could not have died, he could not have risen again. If he could not have risen again, there would be no salvation. It's not an almost salvation, it's an utmost salvation. I'm saved to the uttermost. I know that I am. Why? Because I'm washed in the blood of the precious Lamb. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. Do we really think about Christmas this way? Have our wants overtaken our needs? Have we lost track of our needs? Have we lost track of what we need most in our life? Like I said, this is a time of year to be enjoyed. This is the time of year that we should enjoy our salvation. This time of year that we should enjoy each other. This is the time of year you should enjoy me in this coat. I say, some doing this, some going. You better be glad I couldn't find pants to go with it. I was looking. But you see, it's okay to laugh, and it's okay to smile, and it's okay to enjoy. How can you do that? Why can you do that? Because unto you this day, born in the city of David, a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. You see, Christmas takes a little bit different meaning as older you get. Christmas takes a little bit different meaning as life evolves. Needs become a little bit more of a reality. But the wants are more fun, aren't they? But the needs are what we need. Why did we need that snowstorm last week? I don't have a clue. But for some reason, we did. Whether it be a wake-up call to us, whether it be a preparation call to us, whether it be a call to realize we serve one greater than we are, Because I'm going to tell y'all something. I still serve the God that controls the snow. The meteorologists don't control the snow. Okay? Well, apparently they don't know what snow is. What I've learned.
So where does your joy come from today? Where does your end joy come from today? It comes from a Savior.
The shepherds didn't have a clue. We don't have a clue. But I know this. Oh, what a Savior. Oh, what a Savior
that can allow us to be here today, that can allow this sweet baby to be here with us. I love to see new babies come in. I love these new baby faces. And you know what? It's what's so funny. I bet Jacob done went bought all kind of Christmas presents for that baby. He ain't got a clue. As long as you get him a dime or a bottle, that's all he needs right now.
But don't we do that? That's what we do. Because we want them to have. Last night, we were doing a little Christmas shopping, and it was shoulder to shoulder and bumper to bumper, and I was about ready to kill somebody. You ever been there? But you know, that's what it is. And people love that. People love that hustle and bustle. People love to get out in that and spend time in that. And I don't know why. Thank you, Lord, for Amazon. A Savior.
What are you drowning in today? What are you drowning in today? What's got you bound down today? What's got you pulled down today?
What's holding you? What's keeping you from enjoying? You know, some people may need to give praise for what God did last week. Some people may just need to give praise for what God did in their life last week. I don't know. But my God walks on what you're drowning in today. And you know what? All you have to do for him to pull you up, save me. Pull me out, Father. Pull me out of this place I'm in, Father. Get me out of here, Father. I can't take this anymore. I can't take this anymore. I don't want to take this anymore. So whatever you're drowning in this morning, there's a Savior. Whatever's got you bound, there's a Savior. If you're still a little bit concerned with an almost and not an utmost, there's a Savior. So this morning, this Sunday, we'll be here Christmas Eve next week. We'll be celebrating Christmas together. But this morning, where are you at?
What's God got for you today? He's got a Savior. We know that. But what's he got for you today? As they come with a song this morning.
231.
As you stand with us this morning. What have you got to be thankful for today? What have you got to give praise for today?
You may be here today and you've never met Jesus as a personal Savior. Come to where he is today. But as they sing this morning, let God work in your life and just be real with him today. As they sing this morning. Let him work in your life today. Let him work in your life.